Welcome back. It's time now for 11 Fitness, and Neal Kopasek from the Maryland Athletic Club joins us. Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having us today.
Sure. I'm glad you're able to make it in with all the trees down and all the debris. And you're going to talk today about running and cross training to improve your game. Is that right?
Right. Strength training.
Okay.
Which a lot of runners might tend to shy away from.
Okay. And so what are the benefits if you cross train versus, you know, just running every day?
Well, at the Maryland Athletic Club, we like to emphasize that strength training is good for training the muscles that you actually run with. And it also helps support our frame and our core, so we're up straight with great posture, and it helps us with our breathing too. Not only that, a lot of us runners have some biomechanical type insufficiencies that can be corrected with that also, if properly done.
Okay, so what's the first move?
Well, the first move is, I'd like to say, for the most part, stay on your feet when you're doing your strength training, for the most part. Because that's what we do when we're running. We're landing on the ground, stabilizing, and everything. So I like to show you just a couple of things that are good for that.
Okay.
Like for the lower body, there's an exercise I like to show called the reverse lunge with a knee up and a heel up.
Okay.
Ready?
All right.
Okay.
Let's see it.
So you do a reverse lunge. You come up with your knee and go up on your toe. Okay. So you're using all your lower body running muscles.
Uh-huh. Okay. A little balance move too.
Now you're exercising. Okay.
Okay.
Even a little hop might help make it even more of an exercise.
Okay.
Do each side 40, 45 seconds, 2 to 3 sets.
Okay.
Okay. A good example for using your upper body along with your lower body is something called a bent over row. Okay. Have these nice little colorful weights here for you. Okay. Again, these are only 10 pounds.
Okay.
I use much heavier.
This is just for demonstration purposes.
Just for demonstration purposes.
All right, 10 pounds.
A lot of people do bent over rows, but a good one for running is to stand on one leg and row with the opposite arm.
All right.
That way you're using your back and your leg. Using a stability ball for holding on instead of a bench to make that, again, more of an exercise.
Okay. Okay? But if you don't have one, you're at home, you could use a bench or a chair.
Right, but every home should have one. Yeah, right, you're right, you can use a bench. So you're standing on one leg, rowing with the opposite arm.
Okay.
Make sure your back is straight, your shoulders are parallel to the floor.
Okay.
Use a weight that you can do and become fatigued after maybe 15 to 18 repetitions, 2 to 3 sets.
Okay, because again, I think a lot of people think of running as just a sport for your legs, but
that's exactly right.
It's not.
If we ignore our upper body, we'll be hunched over, won't be able to breathe properly, and that will, of course, lead to injury, and all this helps prevent injury.
Okay, well, those are two easy moves. Anything else that runners should be doing?
Core exercises, of course, for it's not just ab exercises, it's core exercises for the, you know, the deep ab muscles. Can I show you one?
Sure, let's
see. A lot of people have heard of the plank, okay? And that's essentially when you're on the floor, elbows under your shoulders, okay?
Yoga eye move, sockets Pilates over your, move.
Eye sockets over your thumb knuckles, and make sure your back is straight. Hold that for about as long as you can, 2 to 3 times. Another way to make it more of an exercise is to go on your side, stacking your ankles, knees, hips, okay? And then doing each side, maybe one side 20 seconds, a regular plank for 20 seconds, and the other side for 20 seconds.
And that's a lot harder than it looks. If you think he's just resting down there on the floor, he's not, I can tell you.
I'm a paid professional.
Neal, thank you so much. Some
it's
great tips for runners. All right, we'll stay